So probably we can start.
Okay. So, okay, wait a moment. Yeah. Today I will continue to the feedback stabilization of angular momentum system. And we have always the same stochastic mass equation, which is given by this, equation. In fact, this is just the matrix valued Itô's form stochastic differential equation. Okay, I just write the denoted by the deterministic part by the F rho T and the stochastic part by the JT. And the eta represents the detection efficiency of the detector, and eta between 0 and 1. So the rho here describes the state of the system and belongs to the state space, which is denoted by S. Okay, and here we consider always the finite dimensional case. So this is only the matrix and Hermitian positive and trace equals to 1. For the GZ is a diagonal matrix, and the GY is the diagonal part is 0, and it's this part is given by this expression. And for the two parameters, omega is positive and M is positive, where M is here. M describes the interaction between the quantum system. Here is angular momentum system and the probe in the field of detection. Okay, so firstly, I want to introduce the previous work of the asymptotic feedback stabilization of angular momentum system. There are two benchmark work. The first one is the work of Raman van Hendels and the others at 2005. And the second one is Mihaimis and Raman van Hendels at 2008. And for the first work, in fact, what they did is only for the dimension two-dimensional case. And they just by some intuition, they can find, they suppose the feedback controller U in some case. They suppose some, just propose a feedback controller by some observation or intuition. And for example, what they did is something like that. Because in two-dimensional case, in fact, we can write the dance and the operators in this form. Okay, where the sigma x, y, z are the Pauli matrix, so which means we can just write the matrix in this form. Okay, which means now we can characterize our density matrix by just x, y, z, the three dimensional vectors to describe the state of the quantum system for the two dimensional. Normally it's a spin-off system, okay? So just by some observation or intuition, they propose the UT, they suppose, for example, the UT can given by in this form. In this form, and they suppose the target state, okay, because our objective is to stabilize our system toward the target state. They suppose the target state is the ground state, which corresponds to the 0, 0, -1. So we can see that the UT, the U rho J equals to 0, and the U rho E for another antibody eigenstate, the rho E is 0, 1. Mistake. Okay, it's not 0. So it's at least it's a good because under this feedback controllers, our system has only one equilibrium, it's our target state. And what they did is they used the MATLAB, there is some tools, the MATLAB, they call it SOS tools, okay. And they can find, they can construct Lyapunov function such that the Lyapunov function is always negative. So just by the stochastic Lasalle theorem, they can show that the system will converge to the target state. The rho bar, okay. So it's not so interesting, this treatment, because it depends a lot on the computer, on the complexity of the computer. So maybe for the two-dimensional case, it's okay, it's not difficult, but for the high-dimensional case, it's not easy to find the proper Lyapunov function, okay. So what I want to show is for the second part, for the second method, which is this one. In this paper, they proposed, they started the trajectory of stochastic master equations more analytically, and they proposed switching feedback controller to asymptotically stabilize the n-dimensional angular momentum system toward the target state. Okay. Firstly, for the n-dimensional case, I'll call that the spin tree system. Okay. And in the last course, I showed that if u equals to zero, which means if we turn off the control input, if u equals to zero identically, and the system, the trajectories will converge to the site rho 2j. Okay. This is just the matrix 1, 0, 0, 0, the diagonal matrix, and this one is 0, 0, 0, 1, something like that. So here we choose 1. In this subsite as our target state. So this one is our target state. We want to stabilize our system toward this state. And for the others, we call that antipodal eigenstate. The k doesn't equal to m bar, okay. And they proposed a function, which is y, which represents the natural distance between the actual state and the target state, okay? Which means, of course, this is always positive. In fact, it is not only positive, it's between zero and one, okay? And we have the v rho equals to zero if and only if rho equals to rho, the target state. And for any antipodal eigenstate, antipodal eigenstate equals to one for the k. Okay. And based on this equation, we can construct the two subspace of the state space from a fixed constant between zero and one. We construct the two subspace. Okay. The rho between the S. This is the constant between zero and one. So from this, we can construct this. So I drawn this beautiful picture. We can see that this is a function, this is the space of S one minus gamma over two. Okay, this gamma over two. And we can see that in this subspace, there's only one there's only one eigenstate, which means the eigenstate is the row zero, it's a state belongs to this subset E bar. Okay. So in this subspace, S minus one minus gamma over two has only one eigenstate. It's our target state. Okay, which means in this subspace, we have only one eigenstate. It's our target state, row and bar. And in another space, one minus gamma, which means this one, they have the rest, the eigenstate, which means all the antipodal eigenstates belong to this subspace as one minus gamma, okay? So based on this function, the V, one minus trace rho, rho, and bar, we can decompose the target state and the other antipodal eigenstate. And then they started the analysis, the trajectories of the stochastic master equation in four step. And finally, they can propose feedback controllers to stabilize the system toward the target state. Okay, let's start by the step one. Step one is they show that there exists a constant between 0 and 1, such that the space contains all the antipodal eigenstate. It's not invariant. Under a constant feedback controller, which means under U equals to 1, for example. Because it is constant, so here we just take an example equals to 1, which means the probability if exiting such space is positive strictly, okay. And the proof, give the proof. The idea proof, I will give the idea proof is the here, the main truth where they used is called the support theorem. And this theorem is proposed by the Stuck. At 1972, okay. What that means is very powerful tools, in fact, because normally we have the Itô in this, for example, in our system, we have the Itô matrix value, Itô's form stochastic differential equation, okay, which is equivalent to the Stratonovich stochastic differential equation. And we can also, because in the Itô's form, we write the stochastic part like that. And in the Stratonovich, we write something like that. Okay, the circle, the derivative of the Brownian motion. And then we just change this part to some control input, for example, to some function, which belongs to the set. This set is all piecewise constant function, the from the R positive to the R. Okay, then we can obtain the ordinary differential equation. Okay, and what the support theorem say? You see, it's for example, this ordinary differential equation, if there exists a time t, it's finite positive constant t, and there also exists in the function v t belong to such, which means there exists the piecewise constant function such that the solutions of this ordinary differential equation, it's a solution of this equations at time t, at the initial state is given by x, and which we have also this this function is control input, so that at this moment we can enter in a neighborhood of the x bar. And this statement is equivalent to.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm the only one. Okay, it all appeared all of a sudden. It seemed like I was seeing nothing of what you were writing for a while, and then okay. It all appeared. Is it the same for everybody, or?
Sorry,
Yeah, I'm also having delays in the when the things appear on screen.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, so for a while, like, it was like you were writing nothing, and then it appeared all of a sudden. Okay, we'll just deal with that. It's fine.
Well, it seems that it is this problem for everybody, but I think it should be fine. I mean,
yeah, as long if it's not more than a minute or. Now it appeared, but there were some sort of lag.
It's okay, no?
Yeah, now I think I see everything.
Okay, maybe it's something changed.
Maybe just do a pause from, maybe do some micro pause from time to time. So just to check.
Okay. Okay. So this is a solution, the xi, denoted xi by the solution of the ordinary differential equations. Okay, at time t, at the capital T, and the x is the initial value, and the v is correspond to the corresponding the control input, okay, belongs to which is the piecewise constant function. And if at that moment, at the capital T, the solutions can enter in this neighborhood, which means there exists a T, plus T, such that the probability, the XT, I suppose the XT is a solution of Ito stochastic differential equations. And can enter in such neighborhood of the x bar if the x zero equal to x is positive strictly. Okay, so which means the support theorem state these two statements are equivalent. And the further step, what they want to show is they want to show there exists a probability of exciting this neighborhood, this subspace is positive, strictly positive. So what they can do is they can just obtain the corresponding ordinary differential equation, and they show that there exists such piecewise constant function which can make the trajectory solution of the ordinary differential equation exit this neighborhood. So the probability of the solution of the corresponding stochastic differential equation can exit this neighborhood, this subspace, okay? And this is what they did. For the details, I will not give you, can just find in the papers, and it's not so interesting, and it's not so general, the proof. It's a lot of trick techniques. So we pass to the step two. The first step, we show that the probability is positive. And the step two is, we can show that such probability equals to one. Okay, which means for the almost every simple path, the trajectories exit such subspace. On to U equals to one. Okay. The finite time. And how to that? We have already shown that. We can show that the probability is positive. And what we need is to run such probability to one. Okay, for the proof, what we will use is I call that the thinking estimation. Because as far as I know, maybe it's first appeared in the Dinkins book, the Markov precise. And in fact, they have been used in maybe in almost every classical stochastic process book, they discussed such treatment. Okay, and such estimation is the sub, the subspace, the estimation, or the expectation, the tau is the first exiting time from this subspace is smaller than t 1 minus sup. The probability okay, we call this inequality at the Dinkins estimation. Next, if we can show that this sup of the probability is smaller than one strictly, we can show such is finite, right? So what do we have? It's this space is this gamma is compact. And why it's compact? Because we have the state space S is compact. The whole state space is compact. You know, we have in the finite dimensional case, so it's not difficult to show that it's compact. And this is closed, of course, this is compact. And we have, for our solution, the stochastic master equation, we have almost all nice properties. And here, the solution, the stochastic master equation is fairly continuous. Okay, from this two property, what we can show it's there exists the constant positive such that the sup probability from the zero is smaller than one minus C, of course, is smaller than one strictly. Okay. So we have this inequality. This part is smaller than T over Xi, right? And of course, it's smaller, it's finite. So if we have the estimation is, if we had the expectation is finite, of course, we can show that this, we can rewrite here. Of course, we have this. The property, the probability at the first exiting time from this subspace S one minus gamma equals to one. Okay, this is very interesting result because if we if the initial state is in this. It's in this subspace, okay? In finite time, we can always exit this space, which means in finite time, we can always enter in this blue ball, right? With probability equals to one in finite time. This was said in the step one and step two. Step three is for almost every omega, there exists a finite time. And for all t, onto a suitable feedback controllers, called feedback loss. Similar loss is our UT, okay? and the solutions will stay in the S1 minus gamma over 2 and never exit. Okay. So the idea is a proof. We have already defined this function. Okay. In fact, this is our candidate Lyapunov function. We can just calculate the infinitesimal generator of this function and we can obtain the rho times I gy rho number. Okay. And I will denote this part the capital U rho. So if we just take, for example, we just take U equals to minus capital U rho, we have square, right? It is always negative. It's perfect. But the problem is U rho k equals to zero for all k, for all rho k down to this target state, which means it will be zero for all the anti-product eigenstate. It's not a good choice. So we can just choose, we suppose for, now we just consider the case for the all the rho in this subspace, right? Sorry, too big. Okay, because in this subspace, we have only one eigenstate. Is our target state, rho and bar. Only one eigenstate. And we suppose in this space, we choose U equals to minus U rho. Okay. And we denote the tau at the first accident time the from such space. Okay. So from just from the Itô's formula, we have the rho. And we know that if we choose the U equals to the minus capital U rho, and it's always negative, the infinitesimal generator of the V. Okay, so this part is always negative, which means the expression is smaller than U zero. And here we suppose our U zero is between two, one minus gamma. Okay. So just from, just by the super Martingale inequality, we can show that the probability, the sup rho t okay, and of course this is equals to the sup rho t, tau is always the first accident time from the S1 minus gamma over 2. Okay. The probability is smaller than V rho 0 over 1 minus gamma over 2. Okay. They just by applying the super Martingale inequality, we can obtain this inequality. And we know that the rho zero is in this subspace. So the V rho zero is smaller than one minus gamma over 1 minus gamma over 2. Okay, of course, this is smaller than 1 strictly. What does that mean? This means if we start, okay, let's come back to this picture. If we start in the 1 minus gamma in this space, okay, for the ANA initial state in this space, for example, we start here, the probability of exiting 1 minus gamma over 2, okay, which means the probability of entering this space here is always negative, is always less than 1 strictly. Okay. So this is very interesting part because from the step one, step two, we have shown that from any state, we have probability equals to one, we can enter in probability equals to one, enter in this subspace. And if we are here, we have always the probability of exiting with the probability smaller than one strictly. And if we can just follow these trajectories lot of times. Okay, for example, we start here with the probability equals to one, and we exit smaller than one, and we continue equals to one, smaller than one. So which means after finite time, we will state in this neighborhood, right? Okay, I'll give some. And here what we need is only the strong Markov property, because our solution of stochastic master equation also equipped with the strong Markov properties, and just by applying the Borel catalyst lemma, okay, broken lemma, we can show that the probability if the we did not apply that. Okay. This is the exiting time of exit this neighborhood, if exit this or exit this subspace n times, the stopping time, okay, denoted by the tau n. It's finite for infinite many n equals to zero. Why? Because we can easily show that the probability finite, the sum, the n equals to zero to, sorry. We just, it's finite, okay. So just this is by the Borel-Cantalis lemma, we can show such probability equal to zero, which means after finite time, we'll stay, after finite time, we'll stay in this neighborhood, okay. And we'll never get out of this neighborhood. And this is very interesting property because in this neighborhood with only one eigenstate is our target state, right? So which means we have only one target state. We have only one eigenstate is our target state. So we come to the step four. For any rho initial state, the rho t will converge almost surely to the target state under a suitable feedback. Okay. So the proof is also just by applying the stochastic Lasalle theorem, which means the took this function the quantity the abnormal functions, one minus trees rho n bar square. Okay. Of course, it's always belongs to zero and one, and if equal to zero, if and only if rho equals to the target state. Okay, so just by the stochastic Lascelles theorem. We can show the limit LV will converge to the zero equal to zero, which means the rho t will convert to the rho n bar almost assured. Okay. Which means if we now we just consider the case, we're always in this neighborhood and we never get outside of this neighborhood. And in this part, we just take the U equal to minus U rho. And by the stochastic Lascelles theorem, the any trajectories will converge to the target state. Okay. And if we are outside, for example, if we're outside, we choose the feedback controller equals to the constant. For example, here we choose the feedback controller equals to one, and we can opt entering such neighborhood with the property equals to one. Okay. So based on this idea, they proposed the feedback controllers. And also to make the solution to be unique, and we need to consider the interaction part. If the rho t this interaction part through this boundary, and otherwise we take the feedback controllers equal to one. Okay, and then the rho t converge almost assuredly to the rho n bar. Okay, this is the analysis. So we can see that the feedback controllers is switch. Okay, it's not continuous, which means it's not easy to realize in the real practical case. So what I did, based on their method, I make some improvements. The first one is in their step one and step two, they show that there only exists a constant. Okay. There only exists a constant. So what I did is the step one and two. What I did is this constant can be chosen arbitrarily. Which means we can always enter in a very small neighborhood of the target state with property equals to one. The second step, in such neighborhood, what they used is Lascelles theorem. If we use the Lascelles theorem, of course, we can show the convergence, but we have no idea, we have no information on the rate of the convergence. So just the first step four, and we use the local Lyapunov argument. which can give an estimation of the rate of the convergence. Estimate the rate of the convergence. And for the third part is, well, they propose explicit switch feedback controllers. And what I did is we provided sufficient conditions on feedback controllers, okay, so that the rho t can converge exponentially almost surely to the Lewin bar. And under such sufficient conditions, of course, we can construct a continuous feedback controller. Okay. Second part, exponential. Realization. And that gives the reference. This is a collaboration work with Nina and Paolo. Okay. I will firstly provide some preliminary results without proof. Of course, we can find the proof in this paper. Okay, the first one. And we'll assume the feedback controller U, of course, U is it's a function of the actual state. It's a C1, okay, and S2 rho. And this assumption is in order to ensure our solution is unique, okay. Maybe this assumption is sufficient, but maybe it's not necessary. Okay. And the set of all positive definite. It's almost surely invariant. Invariant for our stochastic master equation, okay, which means this site, we call that interim. Okay. Positive strictly is invariant for our stochastic master equation. The second lemma is, of course, under the same situation, under same assumptions for the feedback controllers, you could see one, and the boundary of the state space, okay, the boundary is given by the C. Sorry, zero, for example. Sorry, of course, we have another assumption. Eta equals to one. Eta is the detection of the efficiency. And such boundary is also invariant. Okay. And this two is our assumption. Okay. Eta is equal to one is very important. And the third, quadratic proposition. Yes, we suppose eta belong to 0 and 1. It's an open interval. and u equals to the c1. Here is, we don't choose the one, because if eta equals to one, the boundary is invariant. Okay, we want to avoid this case. And another natural conditions on the feedback controllers is we choose the u at the target state equals to zero. Okay, and we suppose to zero for any zero. For some k and u rho equals to zero. Okay, and this one is we suppose if at initial time our u rho equals to zero, and such conditions can make sure that the our u, the feedback controllers, can be non-zero immediately. Okay, this is why I give these two conditions. And then for n is zero, for some k, and for all epsilon positive, there exists at most only one trajectories. I missed two things. Here, I suppose we have our stochastic master equation is given by the d rho is f rho is d rho equals to f rho dt beta j rho d omega t. This is our stochastic master equation. And of course,
it's been a while since I haven't seen anything, so it's getting hard to follow now.
Oh, okay, sorry. I don't know. Disconnected, sorry. Can you see that now?
Could you just maybe quickly
go over
what's happened? I really lost track of what was going on.
Okay, sorry, it's my problem. I didn't pay attention on that. So at that moment is already when, I don't know, for the lemma or the proposition?
No, I think
the
proposition started to back, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, the lemma were fine.
Okay. Okay, I just start by this. Suppose we have already the stochastic master equation. It's given by in this form, okay? The f rho and the stochastic part. And for the corresponding ordinary differential equations, denoted by this part. Okay, this is our corresponding ordinary differential equation. Because as I said, there is a very powerful tool, is Spock theorem. We can start just by starting the corresponding ordinary differential equation, and we can obtain the properties of the stochastic master equation, right?
Michel, you don't need a kind of control in your ODE, because I mean...
Yeah, you're right. I forgot. Thank you. It's here. And of course, for the V rho, it's in V, which means the Vt is it's piecewise constant function. And our feedback, it appears in this part, okay. So I give some conditions, I give some assumptions for the proposition is we suppose the eta belong to zero and one. And if here is an open loop, because if eta equals to one, the boundary is invariant. We want to avoid this case, okay? So I just, we suppose that eta cannot equal to one. and the u equals to the u is c1 because we give some sufficient condition to ensure the solution is unique. And here is the natural conditions, which means we suppose the feedback controllers is equal to zero at target state, of course. And I also give this assumptions because if for any initial state, our feedback equals to zero, and what I want to do is under such assumptions, f hat, okay, is corresponding to the ordinary differential equation. We want to do is, we give under such assumptions, our feedback controllers will become non-zero immediately, right? Okay, so we have this result is for any initial state, so that for some k, the rho kk equal to zero, rho kk means the rho zero zero to the rho two j, the sum of these diagonal elements are zero. Of course, if some of them are zero, because of course they are in the boundary, right? And what we can show is for any epsilon positive that exists at most one trajectories of the ordinary differential equation, rho v. Starting from rho zero, which lies in the boundary. And for any others, rho zero and the boundary. And for all the control input, okay, for all control input, this control input corresponds to here. I will revisit the trajectories of the ordinary differential equations will become positive strictly, definitely for all t positive. Which means for the other case, the density matrix will be positive definitely, immediately. Okay. But this proposition is a result for the corresponding ordinary differential equations. Okay. So here I have some problem or the question, is it possible for the rho if we have under the same assumptions and same conditions on U, is it possible to show that the solution of the stochastic master equation will be positive definite immediately, almost surely, for all I don't know that this statement is correct or not, but I try to do some simulation. It works very well, but I cannot prove it. But it seems correct. So I don't know if one of you have some idea, please correct me. We can discuss something about that. If we can show this contraction, the conjectures, this can help us. This can, in the following, we can see that it can improve the estimation of the rate of the convergence.
Excuse me, Michel, just one question. When you say conditioned on U, which means that you fix control, you no longer have a control, right? This is what you mean.
Your control means U or V. The control here, you mean?
Yeah.
Okay, there. No.
U is the fixed now, or not, it's not fixed.
Not fixed, any U. We just, the condition means the U is C1, and at target state equal to zero, and the U is, the gradient is here, is non-negative, is non-zero.
Yeah, okay, but I mean, this is U is now fixed. You now want to have rho almost surely positive when you fix your control U and you ask the question if rho is almost surely positive definite. This is what you mean or not?
Yeah, in fact, the U is not fixed. Yeah, of course, the here we fix the U for any fixed U, for example.
Okay, so this just about, this is, okay, so this is a question about when you, about the positivity of transition density, a transition function on some set, right?
This exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, okay, but okay, right.
Well, I'm not sure. It's almost surely, in fact.
Almost surely, yeah, okay.
Yeah. And immediately. In fact, if it's not immediately, it doesn't matter. If infinite time, it can be, it's also well, I mean. Mm. So, okay.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, because here for the in the determinist case, what we show is exists at most one trajectory. So I mean exists only one trajectory in the probability, I don't know. So we have this problem. Okay. Okay, next. I will firstly give the improvement for the to show that we can enter in an arbitrary neighborhood of the target state almost surely infinite time. Okay, I will call that the reachability. We start by the corresponding ordinary differential equation. Okay, and next, just to rank the, because if we show the reachability of the ordinary differential equations, and by the Spohr theorem, we can show the probability is positive strictly, right? And just by the Dinkin estimation, we can run the probability to one. Okay. So the most important is to show the reachability of the ordinary differential equation. Of course, we suppose the equal to zero. And here we suppose there exists a such control input, okay, which is the piecewise constant constant function. Such that for any rho is true in the rho kk equal to zero for some k. We have the rho vt non-zero for t. And assume, moreover, for any rho belongs to this subset and bar, okay, minus equal to zero. I just remind you that our JC is the diagonal matrix, the J minus N minus J, okay, which means we have the JZ, the rho and bar equals to J, rho and bar, okay. And we suppose rho and bar and bar rho choose by and bar, and the variance here is variance about the JZ, which means it's equals to the choice JZ square rho minus choice JZ rho square, okay, the square of the rho of the trees, sorry. It's always positive. We can just show that by the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. It equals to zero if and only if the rho belongs to this subset, which means it's in this form, rho zero to the rho two j, okay? And the rho n here is just the diagonal part. Rho one one, rho two j, okay? It's just the nth diagonal elements. And then for all rho zero, and for all r positive, exist at time, the constant positive, finite constant, sorry. Such that the solution can enter in such neighborhood of the target state. Okay. Give the proof. And in fact, we have already showed that if the trace rho n bar equals to one. Okay, which means the rho equals to rho n bar, okay? And this I denoted by this part, by the rho n bar, okay? It's just a number. Then we calculate the derivative of the n bar for the corresponding ordinary differential equation. Okay, and this is n bar, okay? This is the ordinary differential equation, right? We have obtained this part. Eta m, the pn bar rho v, and the rho v n bar vt, where the first part is given by this form. Minus u rho trace I gy rho n bar, okay, and also plus 4 beta n p n bar rho trace gz. And also, of course, Pn bar rho is the J minus N bar minus trace G zero. Okay. This is very interesting if we have this form. What we want to show is it possible? The question is it possible to find such piecewise constant V? And our control input can make our system, the trajectory of the rho vt and n bar converge to one. Okay, this is our question. So, and another property is because we know that the S, the state space is compact, okay, which means this is always bound constant. Okay, so if this two part is always non-zero, and of course we can always choose the piecewise constant such that it's very large. This part is very large and can dominate the system, which means our trajectories rho vt n bar can converge to one. Okay. So we, in order to discuss this part, I will separate to the two case. The first one is the first case to discuss, because here is the two things to discuss, the Pn and the rho v n bar, okay. The first is under the assumptions we know that there always exists the V such that the U row is non-zero in infinite time, right? Because here is our assumption. Here's our assumption. Okay, we suppose there is always U non-zero. Sorry. Equals to zero. And for the exist of V, the U will become non-zero infinite time. And just by the same proposition, by the same argument as in the proposition three, In this proposition, okay, the same arguments, because here what we show is it will be positive, okay? Just not stronger than that one. We just use the part of arguments in that proposition. We can show that the rho n bar sum be positive, okay? So just without loss of generality, we just suppose that our rho n zero is positive. Initial time is positive, okay? And the second one is we discuss the part of Pn. We'll discuss this part. For the discussion of this part, I will continue to separate to two cases. Okay, the first one is suppose eta bar, n bar equals to zero. If n bar equal to zero, we have the p n bar rho equals to j minus trace rho jz, and this is just equals to zero to j. It's always positive, and P n bar, here the n bar is zero, okay? So I just write as P zero rho equals to zero if and only if rho equals to rho zero. Rho zero, which means the 1 0 0 0, okay? And next for the another, the particular case is if the n bar is the last one, okay? If n bar equal to zero is the first one, n bar equal to 2j is the last one. And the n bar rho equals to minus j. I just repeat the case. The p n bar rho equals to j bar. Okay. The rho n here is always negative, okay, because the rho n between positive and one, and we have also the sum the n equals to zero to j rho n equals to one of these two properties, and then the p to j rho equals to zero if and only if rho equal to rho to j, okay, rho to j is the last 0 0 0 1. Okay, this is very nice because for the P0 and the P2j, it's bounded. It's always, for the n equal to zero, it's always positive, and it is equal to zero if the state is equal to our target state, okay? And for another one, it's the same. So in this case, we have an obvious choice for the control input of the V. So we just choose the V, the constant, P and rho bar rho and the rho and bar, okay? Because we suppose here is always positive, right? So we can just make here the rho and bar, and this is always positive, for example. For example, we choose the n bar equal to zero is always positive. So maybe another choice is good. Just something like that. Okay. Okay. And then we choose the K as a constant sufficiently large. Okay. And then, of course, for any row, for any R positive, there exists a time T such that the row VT in this neighborhood. Okay. Because we just say again this form, we put the VT, okay, in this case, in the first case, the VT equals to the K over the PM bar and the rho M bar, okay. So we put the K is sufficiently large and we can obtain this part. But here is only for the P, we have only the this nice properties for only these two cases, okay, for only, which means for the case where n bar equal to zero and 2g, we have this good property, which means it's always positive or negative. But for the other case, we cannot obtain these good properties. So, let's discuss the n bar between the 1, the 2g minus 1. And of course, for the case that PM bar rho is not to zero, of course, we can do the same thing, right? We can propose the same feedback controllers. Okay, but the problems, what shall we do for the PM bar rho equal to zero? It's a problem. What shall we do? Okay, and in this case, the function between the will become only this one, okay, because the this part equal to zero, so there's no part, there's no set part with only the first part. And moreover, let's see the this part, if the Pn bar rho equals to zero, which means the Jn bar, J minus n bar equals to J zero, okay? So here the J minus n bar square equals to the trace J zero square, okay? So this part minus the trace square is exactly the variation, okay? And here, because there is here a Pn bar, so this part equals to zero, what we obtain is the variation rho n bar minus the u rho the trace g y rho rho n bar. Okay. And other assumptions, well, this part is always positive. Okay. By the assumption. So it's okay. It's done. Right? Because this is always positive strictly, which means we will continue to argument, increase, right? So of course, for this case, infinite time, we can always construct a feedback controllers so that, for this part, we can always find control input V, the piecewise constant, so that we can enter in the neighborhood of the target space, of the target state, infinite time, okay, for the ordinary differential equation. And I just the remark or the, and here we can show the reshapability for the ordinary differential equation, okay. Of course, we can just find almost the, for the stochastic master equations, we can take the thinking, we can almost by the same argument, which means we use the thinking estimation. Okay, and because for our solution, we have the Euler continuous, okay. And also for the this part, is compact. So we can show the probability for overall zero in this neighborhood, the first accident time in this neighborhood, sorry, the first stopping time in the neighborhood of the BN, the first accident entering time, maybe. I give the definition.
It seems that there is again a problem with the
connection
because we don't see anymore anything. You are writing something, right?
Yeah. Okay. You're right. Maybe so.
Okay. Now it's okay.
It's okay? Okay.
Yeah. Perfect.
So we can just apply the same argument by using a Dinkin estimation and a failure continuous over the rho t is failure continuous. Okay, and this subspace is compact. Okay, and we define the stopping time, and which is the first entering time and this neighborhood. Okay, because the R is arbitrary positive constant, which means we can always enter in a very smaller neighborhood as we want. Infinite time, okay. Almost surely, we can show this property equals to one. Okay, I think maybe it's a good place to stop for today's course, I think.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Are there any questions? Well, maybe I have one. Can you show once again the problem you mentioned about going to the domain when rho is positive definite instantaneously, right?
Yeah.
So as far as I can see, this is a question about, if you have a density for the low of rho.
Sorry, right? I can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah, you have your transition function, right? The probability of going from initial state to a particular domain. Mm-hmm. Now you consider domain when your rho is positive definite.
Yeah.
Well, if you can show that this transition function has a density, positive density with respect to Lebesgue measure, mm-hmm. then that's it. It will mm-hmm. be instantaneously positive with positive probability.
Mm-hmm.
So, my impression that this is a question about you have very degenerate control, right? Control, when you replace your Brownian motion by a control function.
Okay.
So wherever you have u is fixed, mm-hmm. and you consider this control problem in which is obtained from your master equation by replacing your wt by a control function.
Yeah.
So this is basically a question about controllability of this system, about this. Hermander type condition for the vector fields.
Exactly.
Yeah. So my question is it possible to calculate the commutator? So it's too a way too complicated. I mean, basically, you need to calculate the commutators of G and F many times. I mean, is there any way you can calculate this explicitly or this?
Yeah. In fact, I have already calculated. It's not so difficult. It's not so difficult because, in fact, here everything in our master equation, almost everything is linear, just several parts. So it's not so difficult to calculate the combinator. But maybe you have some. I've tried to calculate by the way what you said, but nothing can give some good results.
Okay, but do you see? I mean, do you have calculated sufficiently many commutators, do you get the all tangent space or not?
No.
No.
Yeah, because here what we have is only one. I mean, it's not enough. Maybe we can.
Yeah, but I mean, this is what I'm saying. Of course, you have only one control, then you have only one direct line. But when you do the commutators, it can get bigger and bigger, and eventually,
I see. Yeah, I see. But I don't know, which means here, because I have only one, you mean the vector field, of course, but for the other example, we can add another vector field, maybe it works, but I don't know. For this case, I remember, it's for a long time, I remember I do the same calculation, but it doesn't work.
Okay, and another question related to that, it seems that you have proven that this interval, exactly on this slide, you have proven that you can reach any point in the interior of S. Is that correct or not? I mean, you have this domain S, which consists of those
You mean for the ordinary differential equation? For this?
Yeah, just go back to the previous slide. Just here. Yeah, for yeah, this you have interior of S, right? So these are those density matrices which are strictly positive.
I can't follow you. You mean the proposition or?
Yeah, just in the lemma.
Okay, lemma. Yeah.
So you have interior of S, which is which consists exactly of those density matrices which you are interested in. You are interested in, right?
Yeah.
I mean, my impression that when you were explaining the support theorem, you have proven that you can go to any point. I mean, the image was dense. Is that correct or not?
Yeah.
Okay, but then okay. Well, my impression that you have good chances to prove this that you can get.
In fact, what I did is because we have also this part right for the ordinary differential equation. What I did is I tried to use the similar argument in the Dynkin estimation, and what we can show is only there is two possibility, either the either the solution, the trajectories will enter in the interior, either it will, if the for such solution cannot enter in the interior, it will converge to the equilibrium. There's only two cases.
Uh-huh.
This is what I can obtain. So, but I cannot show that for almost all solution will get exit, which means we'll get entering in the neighborhood, in the positive.
But then again, you apply this Borel-Cantelli lemma to show that, so this is maybe they will not get positive immediately, but I see. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, I mean, the interesting part is we have, I will use to show the estimation, in fact, by the by some Lyapunov argument. What I used, okay, is the Lyapunov, there are some root, okay? So for example, the rho, what I use is Lyapunov function, something like that. So in order to avoid the singularity, which means in order to make sure the function is C2 everywhere, because we will use the Ito formula, right? So the square is not a good choice. This is why I want to show this part is always positive. If it's always positive, it's invariant. And moreover, we show that the positive part is invariant. So we can get rid of the problem of the singularity. This is why I want to show that. Because if we cannot show that, we just can restrict our initial state need to be positive, definitely. Because we have shown that this part, the interior is invariant. So it's not for the whole space, only for the interior of the space. So it's not a good choice. I mean, this is why I want to show that almost surely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Are there other questions? Well, if not, I guess I can stop recording.